time is definitely a luxury for me, and that's something that I've realized more so during this lockdown. But as far as products are concerned, anything that's exclusive and bespoke is definitely something that I would consider a luxury. I've actually been following Luxbook since its inception, and I think the team is really strong and they come out with some amazing content, which keeps me abreast with all things luxury. Definitely the importance of family and friends, for sure. I feel like sometimes we tend to take that for granted, and I've learned just how important family is, just to keep you together, you know. I do have quite a stunning collection of limited edition handbags that I've collected over the years, but the one thing for me that would be the most special from that collection is a vintage Chanel brocade handbag that was given to me by my mom, and she's had it for years. So I think that. A pair of Louboutins that were a half size too small for me, and I thought I could stretch it out, but I couldn't. So now they're just sitting in my closet. I think the Tata family is such an inspiration. The Taj group of hotels is definitely a feather in our cap as Indians. And I don't think anything exudes luxury as much as their warm and bespoke hospitality. So it would have to be shopping and baking. Gin and soda. Or shoes, always shoes. I'd like to say fun, but firm. For traditional Indian wear, I'd have to say Sabyasachi. And for a more sort of modern take on clothes, Anamika Khanna. It'd be a toss between Dior and Bulgari. Love, 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 love being part of this. It's a community of like-minded women. And so thank you so much, Luxbook, for including me as part of the top 50.